Oh. Not yet. Easy, man. Easy. Easy. Just a little longer.
They were expecting us. First troops to the bridge. Break through. Vanguard, to the left. And the rest, come with me. We'll fight the bastards.
At them. Charge! Ride those horses into the dirt!
Thank you. is their leader.
What? This boy.
You should show a little more respect, Divish. You'll need it when you kneel before Istvan. Oh, now the pup shows his teeth.
Istvan, you say? Not Sir Istvan? Or Lord Toth? Just how intimate are the two of you?
I know him. He's Erik, Toth's captain and right-hand man.
Finally, some good news. Shackle him and guard him closely.
Those bastards want to destroy our trebuchet.
Hmm. The damage isn't too serious.
So we can shoot?
Not just yet.
Sir, what are we waiting for?
You've heard his threats, Robard. Do you want him to kill Radzik and my wife? We have to consider all our options.
And it would be a shame to destroy the castle, too. But how do we get that rat out of there?
Sir, I might have a solution. What about exchanging hostages? He was the captain at Vranjik. And he brought Istvan's reinforcements here. He seems to be on very intimate terms with Toth. He might be able to tell us something. And he might even be as valuable to his lord as Lady Stephanie and my father are to us.
You're your father's son, by God.
You're a godsend, lad. You're right. We'll interrogate this whore son, and then decide what to do next. Come to my tent when you've rested.
Make your peace with God.
Do your worst. I won't betray my lord.
Ah, Henry. Just the man I want. This fool would rather hang than sing. You know more about him than we do, so maybe you can get something out of him.
Well now, Erik. It is Erik, isn't it? Looks like the boot's on the other foot this time, doesn't it?
Fuck you.
You need to change your tone. If you start being nice, you might just come out of this alive. So now I'll ask you a few questions, and you better think carefully about how you answer them. Who is this Toth?
He's an orphan, same as me. The Turks killed his parents, so he started killing Turks. Sigismund needed men like that, so Istvan ended up in his service.
How did you meet him?
He killed my parents.
What? Toth killed your parents?
You could never understand. They were weak. Istvan strong. He took better care of me than any father.
What is he after?
Are you really that clueless? To destroy Wenceslas's allies. You.
Who does he take his orders from?
Are you stupid? He works for Sigismund.
How many men does he have in the castle?
How should I know? There were nearly 70 of us at the beginning, but there's probably not even half left. But that's still more than there ever were in that castle. More than enough to defend it.
Listen to me. Toth has hostages in the castle, and we have you. So, how about an exchange?
Do you take him for a fool? Do you really think he'd give up the only thing he has that stops you from attacking? He'll never accept an exchange.
You better pray he will, for your own sake. Because once we attack, you'll be worthless to us. And what do you suppose will happen to a worthless bandit? I won't waste any more time on you. You could have saved yourself, but apparently you value your master's skin more than your own.
I don't need to save myself. Istvan will save me. And he'll kill every last one of you.
Why should he save you? He'll sacrifice you, just like everyone in Vranjik and Pribislavice. You're nothing but a common bandit.
You don't know anything. He'll come for me, and anyone who lays a finger on me will pay dearly.
Now I'm curious. Why would he care that much about you? Could it be your lovers?
You'd never understand.
For a while there, I thought we'd get nothing out of him. But in the end, he spilled his guts.
I thought you were much too easy on him. But it seems your approach was the right one. Well done, lad. Anyway, it's clear that young fellow is no ordinary brigand. And he believes Toth cares about him. We'll just have to see if the bastard cares as much about him as Divish does about his wife and you about your father.
Well, Divish, I think the time has come to find out just how much Toth values our hostage. Do you want to parley with him yourself?
I think I'll leave that to you, Hanush.
So be it. I'll do my utmost. Bring the hostage below the battlements.
Sir Istvan!
What is it? Did our neighborly visit catch you unprepared?
A little. But we've settled in nicely. And this fellow is enjoying our company so much, we simply can't get rid of him. It seems we are in similar situations. Perhaps it's time to send our respective guests home.
Not a chance. Do you take me for a fucking fool? Be warned. If anything happens to Erik, I'll let every manjack here have his way with this bitch, and I'll dice Kobila into goulash meat.
Nobly spoken, Your Grace. But for all I know, you may have done that already.
Divish, I'm sorry.
Greetings, friends. Fear not, Lord Toth is treating us like royalty.
They're unharmed, as you can see. But don't try any tricks or they won't be for long, Hanush.
It seems your lord doesn't place any great value in you, boy.
Go to hell.
I'm sorry. Looks like it's not going to be that easy.
Well, at least we know they're alive. I didn't expect much of it anyway.
He won't harm them as long as we have this fellow.
Well, friends, what do you suggest?
I'd say we have no choice but to attack.
It's a great risk, Robard, with Stephanie and Radzig inside.
I know how you feel, sir, but Toth is no fool. They are his last safeguard. He will do nothing to harm them until he is sure of victory.
Would you be saying that if it were your wife inside?
Or your father?
Well, let me point out that we have no choice anyway. We don't have enough supplies to keep men here for weeks, while gangs of brigands and Sigismund's army roam the countryside. Hmm. Toth won't agree to an exchange, and even if he did, we'd have to let him go. With all his men, he'd be a thorn in our sides till Judgment Day.
Sir, a message has arrived.
Oh, what is it?
Margrave Jobst is approaching with his retinue and wants to speak with you.
Jobst, you say? All right.
What is he doing here?
Who's Jobst?
Jobst of Luxembourg is cousin to King Wenceslaus and Sigismund. He's the Margrave of Moravia.
Only a year ago, he was collaborating with Sigismund and the League of Lords. He betrayed King Wenceslaus and his ally Prokop. Now, he's changed sides, appointed himself the leader of the rebellion against Sigismund, and wants to liberate Wenceslaus.
Whichever way the wind blows.
Nevertheless, it seems the decision is made for us. We don't want Jobst camping with us in front of our own castle like a band of gypsies.
I'm afraid you're right, Hanush. All right. We'll let the men rest a while and then attack. Come to me when everything is ready.
Good health to you.
What do you think of Master Keyser?
He definitely knows what he's doing. And all that wild talk of his, rockets and such like. I'd almost let him try it out, but on some other castle.
Do you think there's any truth in it?
I've never seen such weapons used, so I can't really judge. But if his ideas worked, they'd change the way we make war. He showed me some of the drawings he has with him. I don't know if he's a genius or a madman.
There was precious little in it, and we could have lost everything.
That's how it goes in war. But God stood by us. And in the end, they're nothing but a bunch of filthy cutthroats. They're sneak thieves and assassins. But does that make them real soldiers?
Well, they're apt to wait till a man nips off into the bushes to relieve himself, lifts up his chainmail tunic, and stab him in the back. Personally, I'd rather face a proper soldier.
Because you know just who you're up against. That's probably why Toth is giving us such a hard time.
God be with you.
Greetings. What do you need?
We came just in time, didn't we?
Quite. I thought my last I had come. But Lord Capon came to our defense and fought like a lion. I'd say he's growing into a proper nobleman at last.
I think more people will be changing their minds about him.
They should. I owe him my life. God bless him.
Goodbye.
Be praised. What brings you to me?
We came at the last moment.
True. I feared the worst. I had to flee from the Turks once. But this was an even closer shave. But as for our misfortunate Master Feyfar, I fear you may have come too late. I examined his wounds and I'm not sure he's strong enough to pull through.
That is too bad. Too bad that you weren't able to escape on time.
Yes, Sir Capon took fright. Understandably, for someone his age. But not to worry. A little practice in killing foes would put steel in him.
Take care.
ya.
God be with you, lad. What can I do for you? Take care.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's going on?
How are things with you?
I'm worried. I've a bad feeling about all this.
How's that?
I couldn't say. I just feel it in my guts. Like when you eat something bad and you have to keep running to the outhouse. Or maybe I ate something bad.
Jesus. Must you disturb me with such a thing when I'm fast asleep?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
God bless you. What troubles you?
How do you feel?
Pissed off. I'd give anything to have seen you get here sooner. If only Istvan had stayed inside that fucking castle.
I remember the first time it happened to me.
But that was when you were a young blacksmith when those thugs attacked you. I'm a nobleman trained in combat and siegecraft, and even I... Well, I won't pretend I wasn't terrified.
That's how it goes. There's nothing you can do about it.
But Master Feyfar may not survive the way they hacked him. If I'd been quicker, or if he'd at least started to run, but I...
The main thing is it will be easier next time. You won't feel the horror quite so much.
I hope so, Hal. Or I'll soon be getting sick of your pontifications.
Take care.
See you later.
That was years ago, against the Turks. Sigismund was on good terms with his brother.
Even so, it seems a bit peculiar to me.
Greedy.
Good luck, then.
Yeah!
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm glad you came.
At your service, sir.
I'm about to give the order to bombard Talmberg.
And since it's mainly thanks to you that we still have a trebuchet, I think you should have the honor of the first shot.
But, sir, I have no idea how.
Master Keyser and Master Feyfar have prepared everything. There's nothing to it. The men will load the trebuchet. All you have to do is pull the lever.
Well, I suppose I could manage that.
Then we'll bombard Talmber for several days. Sir Robard will explain what comes next. Take care.
Load the trebuchet! Good day. Take care.
Divish said,
"Sir Divish."
Sir Divish said, "You tell me what happens next."
Aye. We're going to watch Istvan shitting himself.
That's all.
For a few days at least. So if you have anything to attend to, now's the time. Just don't forget to come back.
See you later.
Thank you.
Is something the matter?
A few of them have taken to their heels. If they stop in Kutenberg, I'll be glad enough. But I fear they may have other plans.
If those were the best of Ishvan's men, they could be lurking in the woods. They'll probably wait to attack us at the worst possible moment.
My fear, exactly. I won't breathe easy until Toth is hanging from the gate. But in the meantime, I'll be glad to know the woods at my back are clear. Can I count on you?
Of course, Sir Robard. Would you like me to bring back their gear as evidence they're dead?
That's not necessary. I trust you, Harold. You don't even have to do the killing, just let me know where you find them and that'll be that. There's no need for you to get hurt in the process.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the wrong place at the wrong time.
Oh. Two arms! Get over here! Hello! Over here! Where is everyone?
Giving up already?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah!
Yeah! Ow.
Yeah.
Hey, who's there?
Well, I never...
Had enough?
Over here! Clear it, everyone! Quick! I'll slaughter you!
If you are, watch out!
You're weak at the knees.
Ready to bleed. Thank you.
Cost you your life.
Ah!
Show what you're made of.
What was that? No.
What are you doing here? Tired of life, are you? You can still yield.
Thank you.
I found all of their campsites. The rest of the woods are clear.
That's a relief. Now let's relieve ourselves of this accursed Toth.
Good luck, then.
God save.
About trans.
Yes.
I've got my own merchant.
See you later.
Yeah. Yeah.
God save.
Have you still got...
We did.
I'd still like to buy...
And how we...
I've got a merch...
Well, what do you say to...
Nah, that's too...
Try some... Good luck, then.
Marsh, back up.
Fucking come on then!
You're done for, fucker! I'm gonna enjoy it! You get what for?
God. Is that all? Show what you're made of!
Your end is nigh!
How about a little bet? What do you say? How about a small wager, my good man?
That depends. A wager over what?
It's simple. I tell you a riddle. If you solve it, you get back twice the sum you wager. If you don't, I get to keep your coin.
Who might you be, anyway?
Me? No one important. But you can be sure of one thing, lad. I walk the world, collecting riddles, stories, and sometimes arms. I live from day to day. But enough of my babbling. Do you want to engage your mind?
That sounds good. Let's do it.
Now, listen carefully. In the feast hall, on the table, are 10 candles. Suddenly, a gust of wind throws open the window and blows out 2 candles. A little later, another candle goes out. The servant, therefore, closes the hall window. Now the wind cannot blow out any more. So how many candles can the servant find to relight the following morning in the hall?
Can you repeat that?
Certainly. In the feast hall, on the table, are 10 candles. Suddenly, a gust of wind throws open the window and blows out 2 candles. A little later, another candle goes out. The servant, therefore, closes the hall window. Now the wind cannot blow out any more. So how many candles can the servant find to relight the following morning in the hall?
None.
No, no, my fine fellow. The correct answer is 3. While the wind blows out 3, 7 burn down completely overnight, so the next day only 3 can be rekindled. Oh, don't you fret. Very few people can figure out my riddles. So, I thank you, and may we meet again sometime.
Not if I see you first.
Good morning.
Good luck, then.
My wooden bed. I'm from Skelitz, and, well, you know,
Look what I've got.
Cucumbers, onions, come and get it.
I'm honored.
See you later. With you.
Let's have a word about the pride. What do you say to this?
That's not enough. All right, so.
Cucumbers, lovely cucumbers.
Flour, eggs, salt, yeast. Let it bake a bit, and you'll be able to feed the whole family with fresh bread.
God grant you.
Take care.
Thank you.
Good health.
It's looking like a siege. The soldiers are out patrolling. In case them dogs try to make an assault, the lords are pondering how to get in and building a siege engine.
What? A siege engine? Do they want to demolish the castle? Sir Divich won't be too happy about that, will he?
I suppose not. And he got wounded pretty bad when they tried to take the castle before. But if they're building a siege engine, we'd have to give the go-ahead, wouldn't we?
Aye. I suppose there's no other way. Talmber Castle is strong.
On the other hand, how can they bombard the place? Now Sir Radzik has been taken prisoner and locked up there.
Christ almighty! I never knew that.
Aye. They wounded Sir Divish and captured Sir Radzik. It's a serious pickle they're in now.
Let's pray they both come out of it all right. God's help.
And may all the saints watch over them when they attack the castle.
Yeah.
My hum.
I'm.
So what?
Proper.
I'm sure you're.
Good luck, then.
I've got something. I got them from Uncle Peshek. Just don't go poking them where you shouldn't.
They're lockpicks. They're not really intended for poking in your own locks.
True, but at least don't get caught. And if you do, you didn't get them from me.
Wouldn't you like to take a stroll somewhere?
I'd love to.
Oh, already.
Don't you want a little wager?
See you another
on the
time,
rat,
then.
Eh,
yeah. Yeah.
My humble...
About transporting the stone to Pribis Lavis.
Yes.
I've got my own...
Splendid!
All right. Here you are.
Excellent. We'll start sending the stone as...
Thank you.
Hey, you bastard! What are you doing, creeper?
Blood will be spilled.
I'll have you. You get what you are.
Follow. Boa, yeho.
Don't weak at the knee, have you?
No! What have you got? You call that combat? Yeah.
I want to build something.
Certainly, Master Bailiff. What's it to be?
Oh, we don't have a tavern here yet. People need to wash the dust down after a hard day's work.
Right. That should do it. We've got everything we need to start building. Come with me.
Help! Help! We're going to build here?
Yes. Shall we get started?
I'm ready.
I'll just quickly check again that we have everything we need. We've got what we need. Let's get to work.
God's sake.
Take care now.
Work to be done. Marius, there's work to be done. There's work to be done.
That shouldn't take too long.
Come along with me and we'll take a look at the site.
Here?
Right here. Ready to start?
I'm ready.
I'll just quickly check again that we have everything we need. All good. We can start construction.
I'll have to get something to eat. I'm starting to get hungry.
Marius, there's work to be done.
Come along with me then, and we'll start building.
We're going to build here?
Right here. Ready to start?
I'm ready.
I'll just quickly check again that we have everything we need. We've still got the means. We'll get stuck in then.
Thank you.
Da!
Have some truth.
Show me. So many. My lad, you're like the smiting right hand of God.
Since Sir Divish's colours still aren't flying over Talmberg, I suppose we'll be attacking.
Just so. That Istvan's a stubborn bastard.
All right. When do we start?
There's no reason to wait. Are you really ready? If you need to rest or anything, we can still wait. You won't have another chance until we've won the day. Or until your final rest.
I'm ready.
Glad to hear it. We're going to attack on two fronts, the north gate and the west wall, which will scale with ladders. The attack will be split into different stages, taking the outer walls, the inner bailey, and finally the core of the castle and the tower.
How are we going to attack the gate?
We'll try to do as much damage as we can with the trebuchet first. Keyser claims he can even hit it directly. Even if that's true, we'll have to charge through a downpour of enemy arrows all the way to the portcullis.
Portcullis?
Fortunately, it's wooden, so we'll be able to break it down. But dealing with the defense in the bailey won't be easy.
And what's the plan for attacking the west wall?
First, we have to get men to the wall with ladders, which is no easy matter under fire, so we'll need as many men covering them as possible. As soon as the ladders are in place, our foot soldiers will run up and try to scale the wall. Once a few of them get to the battlements, we should quickly gain the upper hand.
How will we take the battlements?
Either by scaling the west wall, or our men at the gate will help. If they can break through, that is.
And the inner bailey?
That will be tough. Even if we get through the gate and into the outer bailey, we're still a long way from victory. The castle is designed so we'll be like hens in a coop to anyone with a bow on the inner battlements. We'll have to either fight our way through, or somehow get around them.
What about the living quarters?
There, I'm worried most about the hostages. Once we're inside, Istvan will know defeat is inevitable, but we'll still have to fight for each and every room.
I think I've heard everything I need to know.
Do you want to join the attack on the walls or on the gate? Remember, many of the Scarlet's men will follow you. It could make a big difference.
I'll help with the attack on the walls.
I'm proud of you, Henry. You've changed from an insolent pup into a tough, reliable fighter. And as God is my witness, we will kick those whore sons' arses.
A village lad and an old soldier. This man must be shaking in his boots.
Ha ha. If he's not shaking, then he doesn't know what he's got coming. Just one last thing, though. No matter how good the plan is, something always gets fucked up. Keep your eyes open and take advantage of every chance. Help your comrades and don't go rushing in where you're outnumbered. We have to take the castle gradually, one position after another.
I'll remember that.
Good luck to you, stripling.
Good luck to you. Old soldier.
Good luck, then.